What's the meaning of life?
Come on.
What's the meaning of life?
That sounds about right.
This little guy, he's called Leftovers Bot, and he basically hangs around Instagram and waits until people post pictures of their food, and then asks them if they're going to eat all that.
I think it's important that we, as we displace labor, we're all displacing labor, that's all we do all day, we help train people for the future. I think that's a very important thing for us to do. So I made Autonomous Truck Driver Simulator 2017. And you can see, hopefully, maybe some of you can see, right now, we're driving in a truck on the road, and it goes on forever, and you don't do anything.
I got an email last week from LinkedIn saying that there were 160,000 jobs available in my area. And I thought that was weird because I applied for like 80 jobs in the last year and I never heard back. And I realized the reason is because my cover letter is not long enough and it's not big enough. And so I blew up my cover letter 25 times the size. All right.
There we go. Wearable technology, and so everyone knows that LSD microdosing is the future of nootropic technology, and for enhancing productivity in the workplace, there's nothing like little spurts of LSD. This is proven science. So using a bog standard nipple-based interface, and our water pet, which has a QR code so that they can't use other people's. Just kind of stick it in there, and it stays in usually. And then you adjust the dosage. And yeah, it's like one twist is a patent, two twists is a $1 billion company. It's easy.
Patience is something that I've been told I don't have enough of. I've been told that a wash pot never boils. But I did a graph of how long it takes a pot to boil, and this is that. And then I timed it while watching it, and it's the exact same fucking graph. which made me unhappy. And so these two fine folk, Alex and Moto, put together the wash pot that never boils, which has a demo in a second. It runs off the Raspberry Pi with a camera that anytime a face is looking at it, it turns the kettle off. So here's the demo, and if you have some patience, it might work.
There we go.
Okay, sweet. So blue raver kettle. And if you watch it, it stops working.
Yeah, so I really like this app called FaceApp. It allows me to kind of live in an augmented reality where I look amazing and other people are smiling even when they're not. And I like it so much that I decided that I just wanted to live in FaceApp all the time. So I built an augmented reality app here with Google Cardboard, and it basically captures a frame you know, several times a second and sends it to the FaceApp API. And it just makes everyone be smiling all the time, so you can just be in a utopia where no one's ever unhappy.
I'm here to present a new SaaS product that is Sincerity as a Service. Okay, so I have a hamburger here that I'm about to eat, but I really like to say grace, but both of my hands are full, so. So the way this works is you show it what you're eating. I have not tested this with a real hamburger before.
Give it a second. Reflecting on this breakfast, consideration for to the cow for converting grass into tasty beef with thoughts for the less fortunate families than us. Let us begin his meal.
everyone here will agree that blind dates are great, right?
Yeah.
Of course, yes. But what's the worst thing about blind dates? They're not blind enough. If you could only leave every aspect of your love life to chance, I'm sure it will all work out. And that's why we built Double Blind Date, an app that matches you at a random time with a random person, picks a random activity for you two to do, and then orders lifts to take you both there so that there's no backing out. No one knows who you're going to go meet or what you're going to do with them. What could go wrong?
So we've all had that problem where we're reading erotic slash fiction and the characters are just not in character. It totally throws the whole game off. While I was thinking about this problem, and I was reading dinosaur comics, I was like, yeah, this is a really good niche to start with, you know, like, you need to know your market. So let's find some erotic fiction. So we can, they're like talking dirty to each other. It doesn't make any sense. This is not how Sherlock and John behave with each other. Well, let's click on this little deducify Chrome extension.
Do you ever have a day that's so good you just want like strangers to insult you? So some people do, and that's why there is the subreddit r/roastme, which is, you know, where people go to be insulted. And we decided that's not fast enough to make you feel bad. So we now have this bot that you can PM your pictures to, and it will just insult you based on that. It uses open face to match your face with someone from roastme and then takes a random comment.
We decided websites are generally too big, so we decided to make a complete audio-visual experience in one TCP packet.
That's to me an MTU of 1500.
Yeah, MTU of 1500. So this is using a generative algorithm to make sine waves to make the music, and the visuals are also, someone else made the visuals, I made the music. So the visuals and music are both about 120 bytes each, which leaves us with some bytes for an advertising opportunity. So if you have an ad, that's about 120 bytes or less.
I bet people have been in a position where nobody has really flushed the toilet. And this is a world where we have supercomputers in our pocket. We feel that we can outsource this work. So if somebody fails to flush the toilet, this toilet will inspect the situation and provide it to somebody who can make a proper decision, be it a crowdsourced opportunity or Amazon Mechanical Turk.
Many online communities these days use a voting-based post ranking, and it works super well. No downsides at all. It's great for everything, and no one could ever complain about it in any way. But like all good things on the internet, it needs to be brought into the real world, where it's going to be even better, and nothing can go wrong. So we made thousands and thousands of upvote and downvote stickers, which I'd like you all to take.
You know how like so-called women's pants, they don't have functional pockets, or sometimes they don't have pockets at all. So here's a pocket, and it can fit an iPhone or whatever very easily, right? Unlike women's pockets. And you can just attach this to your pants.
We need her to do a pocket.
And now I have a fully functional pocket. So if you've ever been on a bike, then like cars will buzz past you, so they'll like come by really close, and you'll like die nearly. And so there's this law that's actually the 3 feet for safety act, so cars should pass 3 feet to the left of a biker or whatever. And to enforce this, we have this thing, and so it extends about 3 feet out from your bike, and on the end is a key. conversational abilities that come from advancements in AI and natural language processing. But if you've ever messed around with one of these tools, you've probably noticed that they just don't feel that natural, right? There's always this little bit of clunkiness to them. So what I decided to do was try to make a very authentic conversation bot. And the thing that makes my conversation bot extremely authentic is that the more you talk to it, the more it ignores you.
Everyone, so I'm pleased to announce today a new product that we've been working on for some time here, and we call it the Notifier. And I really encourage you all to just take a look at this thing. It's a beautiful piece of machining. It's a unibody enclosure. It's actually been CNC'd out from one piece of material. It's a really precise manufacturing process. And we're really pleased about the features on this device, too. Finally, we have a rectangle you can stick in your pocket and get notifications delivered seamlessly to it. You can get these notifications 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and they come straight to this rectangle. There's always something that's going to make this rectangle buzz, and these things never stop. This will keep going all the time. You know, again, just take a look at how pretty this thing is. Gorgeous ID on this. You can get notified while walking down the street. You can get notified while eating dinner. You can get notified while watching the sunset. And you can even get notified during your most intimate conversations. This is the perfect technology for people who are skeptical of technology, for people that are aware of the attention they devote to things, for people who follow app pin board, for people who have turned off all of their device notifications. You know, the thing that I really like about this is it totally solves phantom ring syndrome. I'm no longer thinking something's buzzing in my pocket, because this thing is just buzzing all the time. And it's a constant reminder that maybe, you know, I've started paying too much attention to the world around me in the last 60 seconds since the thing buzzed. And really, isn't it time to listen to a small rectangle?
You've been on a bike or in a car, and you wanted to give, like, feedback to other drivers, except, you know, all you have is, like, a bell or a horn or your finger. You know, and so you're like, man, I really wish I could give people some better feedback. Well, you still can't, but this thing at least gives emoticons to other people that may or may not actually match what you're feeling. So, there's one BBC Microbit mounted up here at the front, and I'm going to take it off for the demo. And then there's another one on the back of the bike here, and each one of them has a little LED grid. And when you push the button on the front, then it demonstrates a random emoji on the back. So, you know, if you're feeling happy, you can hit the button, and maybe it'll show them a skull instead. But maybe it won't. Then, it even gives you feedback on the one on the front about what emoji, and they don't match, so it's great.